hurricanes, perhaps. No shortage of questions here at this G7 summit in France.
There was another question, at least one other, about the climate sessions. So all the world leaders were getting together to address all of the climate crisis.
While the Amazon is burning.
The Amazon is burning. And then we just have this picture, Jim, of an empty seat. And that's where President Trump was supposed to be seated. So do you have some reporting on what happened here?
Yeah. I mean, honestly, that empty seat, I think, symbolizes where the United States has been on the issue of climate change for the last few years. It has been an empty seat when it comes to confronting the issue of climate change. The president has said in the past that he believes climate change is a hoax. But in terms of what happened here at the G7 summit, I'm told by a White House official that it was a national security staffer who sat in the president's place during that meeting that was attended by other world leaders, other heads of state from other foreign governments here at this G7 summit. One thing that we should point out, the White House Press Secretary Stephanie Grisham put out a statement saying, well, the president couldn't make it to the climate session here at the G7 because he was having these bilateral meetings with Chancellor Merkel of Germany, Prime Minister Modi of India. And we should note to our viewers that Prime Minister Modi of India and Chancellor Merkel were at that climate session here at the G7 summit. And so we're not getting a lot of straight answers. Perhaps we'll get some. Perhaps we won't get some at this joint press conference when the President Emmanuel Macron come out here in just a short while. But it's just sort of been this typical one confusing episode after another that we're seeing at this summit, and we've seen this play out at other summits in the past. The president will come out and declare all this a big success. He'll talk about this trade agreement that has been reached on principle with the Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, but it's just been one confusing episode after another distraction throughout this G7 summit over a fairly short period of time, we should point out, in a very beautiful part of France, we should also note.
And whatever is said at the news conference, we should also note it's a long ride home with Wi-Fi in that airplane, so a lot more could be said on Twitter.
That's
Jim Acosta
right.
In France, thank you very much.
Itchy Twitter fingers, exactly.
CNN on the front lines of the battle to save the Amazon. Thousands of wildfires. Look at these pictures.